Hello, everybody. This is Julie and Leanna's new horse named Confetti, and we don't know if he's ever been clipped before, so we're going to try to help him learn. So this is the vibrating bug. We're going to start off with this, and then we're going to move to the clippers. So I'm going to go to his shoulder first because that's the least threatening area. And I'm going to stay with him. He doesn't like the sound of it. So I'm going to stay with him until he relaxes. If I take it away when he shies away, then I'll teach him to focus on it. So he did something that showed he was relaxing, so then I took it away. I'm going to bring it back. He's frozen.
Mm-hmm.
So he acted curious. I'm going to take it away and then I'm going to approach him on the other side. Now I'm going to hold it there till he quits flinching. So when I first put it on, he was like that. So I just hold it there till he relaxes. Confident, I'll want to move it closer and closer to his head because I'm going to need to clip his ears and his bridle path and his nose. So if I would have taken it away when he threw his head, then I would teach him to throw his head to get away from it. So I want to leave it there until he relaxes.
What does that do?
This gets him used to the vibrating feel that the clippers are going to have. So they're naturally scared of the vibration. There, so he went down to eat. I'm going to try the other side. See how he kind of flinched when I first came up to it? So I'm going to keep it there till he quit flinching. Then I'm going to try the other side. It's just approach and retreat. So we want to do it till he quits flinching so much and eventually get it to where we can go higher and higher. I'm going to do the back side of it. I'm just going to hold it there until he relaxes or quits trying to fight it at least. So he doesn't like the sound of it in his ears or the feeling of the vibration. So I gotta make sure whenever he throws his head or acts resistant that I don't take it away right then, because then it'll teach him to throw his head to want to get away from it. Because that sound is loud when it's up near his ear. So I want him to know that even if he acts like a giraffe, that the vibration can go as high as he can.
Luckily, he's short.
Yeah. Because I'm short, too. So I took it away when he brought his head down, because going down is positive, going up is bad. Is to hurry up and relax instead of get scared and fight against it. So if I go straight for his head, that's pretty threatening, so that's why I went towards his shoulder. I'm going to do this, and I'm going to try touching his ear. So that way it's vibrating as I'm touching it, because that's kind of how the clippers are going to feel. He's keeping his head still, but he's like curling it away from me, like he's resisting me. I'm going to try that on the other side. I'm just going to hold it here, because now he's actually feeling the vibration on his ear, which can be pretty loud. Stand right in front of him, because if a horse gets upset enough, they could paw at me. Also, it tickles the hair in their ears. Makes kind of a tickling noise. I got him where I could touch his ears earlier without anything, but now touching it with something that vibrates is a little more scary to him. So that was something positive. So I'm gonna take it away and try the other side. Obviously, this isn't something that we want to do the day before the show. We want to work on this and get it good so that we don't have to be stressed out the day before. This horse supposedly has had his ears twitched before to have stuff done to him, so he's a little worried about things. So he's trying to find a way out of it, so I just leave it there until he relaxes and does nothing, because I don't want him to try and escape it. Stand in front of him when I do this, because if he raises up his head, my nose can get broken. So he's licking and chewing and showed some sign of relaxing, so that's why I retreated away, and now I'm approaching on the other side. So now he's actually letting me touch his ear.
Wow.
Now I'm going to retreat away and go to the other side. He has to learn to trust me on this. So my hand has to be able to follow him. Me for a while, so I'm going to retreat away. I'm going to go to the other side. So I just follow him. If he throws his head up, my hand goes with him. There we go, that was good. So he was sitting there for me. So now I'm going to retreat away and go back to the other side. is about like watching paint dry, but if you can do this really, really well, you'll be loving it the day before the show when you can just pull out your clippers and clip your horse, and it's not that big of a deal anymore. But if you try and force it on him and rush and get it all done, then it'll just be a battle. Look at him licking and chewing right there, so I'm going to retreat away. And you have to also be careful to keep your hand with him, because if you don't, I can accidentally bang him in the head with this thing, and then it'll make him more scared. So even though he curls his head, I don't want to be standing right there. Because we don't know him very well yet, and we don't exactly know the reactions that he might have. Oh, he's licking and chewing. So now I'm going to take it away.
He loves you, Jody.
I like this Effie. So now what I need to be able to do is rub this thing on the... He's licking and chewing, so I'm going to retreat away. But he's letting me touch the back of his ear, but I need to get him to where he'll let me touch the opening of the ear, because that's where the actual clippers are going to be. So that's where I'm kind of working towards. Like, he's letting me go on the back. And the front is sometimes where they're a little more worried, just because it tickles the hair. So now I'm going to try to go to the front of the ear. And also it's louder on the front. He can hear that motor going, you know? So I'm just going to hold it there. Same thing. So he was okay with the back, but now I've moved on to something a little more challenging, and he's... He held it there pretty good for me. He wasn't completely relaxed, but it was an improvement. So now I'm going to go to the other side. I'm going to try to get the same thing done. And the only time I might put pressure on the leader up is when his head's up in the air. But if he starts to drop his head, then the pressure can come off of the leader up. So I'm just going to follow him. So if I take it away from him right now, he'll learn that the way to get out of it is to fight it. So he let me touch the front of his ear, so that's why I retreated away. There, he's letting me touch the opening. The battery's nearly dead, so it's actually a lot more quiet, which is good because it's building up his confidence. Good, so that's the feeling that he needs to have right there when I put the actual clippers on him. He needs to be able to go to feel that up and down. He's even licking and chewing right there. So we'll see if we can get that same thing on this side. On this lead rope, because when he does the right thing, he's got to have release. And chewing, that's good. That's good. I'm gonna go to the other. A little bit of resistance, but not as bad as last time. So maybe if I tilt my head, it'll go away. So So this hand has to be watching what it's doing, because when he's close to me, I gotta have release. There we go. Another thing he's gotta be able to do is do a bridle path, so I gotta be able to put this up between his ears. I'm gonna come to the other side. I'm gonna go between his ears. That's good, I'd rather him go down than up. Hold it there, so I put a little bit of pressure on that lead rope. And then when he drops, he's going to put a slack in that lead rope. It came down a little bit, so I just let him put slack in it. Thing I need to be able to do is on his face. He has a little weed here, he's saving it for later. Okay, I need to be able to touch his nose with this thing, because usually they'll freak out when you touch their nose with something that vibrates. So I'm just gonna hold it on his nose. But my hand has to follow him, because if he throws his head and leaves my hand behind, then he just learned to throw his head to get away from it.
Oh, it's going. Okay, go ahead.
Make sure it's all clean under here, and then also on the other side. Now do both sides. And some horses have whiskies over here. You just want to clean it all up so it's really flat on their face. And if you want to, you can do the whiskers. Some people don't want to do the whiskers, so you don't have to. I like to do mine. I think it looks better. But some people like to leave them on as feelers. So you basically just trim off all the whiskers if you choose to do that. So you for sure need to do under here. And if you want a bridle path, then up there.